Hey, this is Anthony Davis with Shapeshift Wellness. And in this video, I'd like to just talk about the importance of being wrong. So I recently shared on Instagram, Facebook post that simply said, being wrong is a good thing. And it really is. I think that as a healthcare student currently, I'm a chiropractic student, about in the middle of my program. And I'm noticing that, and I've noticed this really all my life, that people have a tendency, myself included at times, but I work really hard not to have this tendency, to be afraid of being wrong, to be closed off to information that doesn't confirm beliefs I already held. And there's a huge problem with this. Unfortunately, there seems to be a bit of a schism between science and things that are more philosophical and, you know, emotional and or spiritual in nature. And I think that's a really silly thing. Anything that you do can be scientific if you apply a certain amount of rigorous method to how you go about searching for truth in that subject. So in science, there's no science versus religion. There's no science versus spirituality, because again, any of those things, spirituality can be practiced in a scientific way. Science is an activity. Science is not a stagnant thing. Science is not a set of beliefs. Science is not a set of truths, even. Science is just an activity. You do it. You do science. And what that is an activity in which you systematically try to come up with a hypothesis. You come up with a guess, how you think the world works. You test that somehow. And then you look at what happened when you tested it. Were the results of your experiment the way that you expected them to be? If so, can you repeat that? Can you do it again? Can you do it again? Can you do it again? If so, then your hypothesis, your guess about how the world works in that scenario is somewhat likely to be true. However, if you test that and it's not true, the results of your little experiment don't go the way that you expected, then you immediately learn something. You were wrong, but you immediately learn something, and you can modify then. And you say, well, okay, so it wasn't quite the way I thought it was. Well, maybe it didn't work because I need to change this one aspect of what I thought was true, because I was wrong, but maybe if I change this one thing, then I can get this, I can have a successful experiment. So all of your life can be like that. You have little experiments daily and in periods of your life throughout childhood, then teenage years and young adulthood, etc., where you experiment with social behaviors. What happens if I act out? What happens like the first time that you say no to your parents, right? That's a big moment, and something is going to happen. You're experimenting. You know, you've been. They tell you what to do. They tell you when to go to bed, and then you say, one of these days, you work up the courage to do a little experiment. You say no, and depending on how they react and what happens, that was either a good idea or it's a bad idea, right? You're either going to get maybe punished or reward, or you're going to get what you want, or it depends, right? And that's going to start to instill in you these beliefs about the world based on how people respond to your behavior. So anything you can do can be approached in a scientific way if and only if you are willing to be wrong. You must be willing to be wrong. Otherwise, it's not science. It's just you acting on your beliefs. So again, science is a method of trying to come to a truth about the world. And if you're unwilling to be wrong, then you will never, ever reach any form of truth, period. I'd like to point out that there are a couple different types of truth in the world, right? So there are some subjects in which truth is a very subjective thing. It's a very personal thing. Things like, what should I do with my life? What kind of job should I have? Who should I love? You know, how should I love? Those are going to be personal things that you're going to have to experiment with, explore on your own. But if you approach it with the mindset of science, you can then say, well, you know, it really didn't work when I tried to reconcile my relationship through gifts and flowers. That didn't work. If you keep trying to repeat that, then you're not practicing with a scientific mindset. But if you modify, if you say, well, I was wrong to think that in this relationship that flowers were enough to mend the damage that I did, then if you're willing to change that and say, well, maybe I need to dig deeper. Maybe I was wrong about that. Maybe I can do better. You might come up with a solution that leads to success, but it only happens if you're willing to be wrong. So in all of your life, my life personally, I feel very deeply about being wrong constantly. In fact, science is really cool because it inspires you to try to be wrong as quickly as you possibly can, not punish being wrong. Because if you punish yourself or if other people punish you for being wrong, you're not actually gonna make fewer mistakes. You're gonna keep making mistakes. You're gonna keep being wrong. But it's going to teach you that you need to be quiet about being wrong. You need to never ever admit when you're wrong. And then there's no progress, there's no growth, there's no evolution personally or collectively whatsoever. So one of the things that one of the reasons why this is so important to me is that in my own life, I spent years being wrong about everything. And in drug addiction and alcoholism and unhealthy codependent relationships and all of these things, my choices, my behaviors and actions, addictions, they put me in the hospital several times, and literally it was I could either admit being wrong or I would die. And it's not going to be as dramatic for a lot of people, but it shows you that by being willing to question and be wrong about fundamental things, really fundamental things that you take for granted every day, the way that you believe you are, who you are, what you love, who you love, everything could be wrong. And if you're open to that possibility, then all of these new possibilities open up for you, and you find that you can be and do amazing things with your life. But it starts with being wrong about things and then improving on it constantly. Well, anyway, so that's probably enough on the subject of being wrong. I just encourage you to go approach things like politics and things like healthcare, things that you feel really passionately about. I encourage you to be willing to have conversations. And when people approach you with information that contradicts what you believe, be willing to be wrong. Because when you're wrong, you can then become, you can gain new knowledge that leads you even closer to the real truth. And that could be a subjective truth, so it could be a truth that is true only for you, but it's still closer to your truth, if you will. Or that could be a scientific truth, where collectively we lead ourselves away from error, away from inaccurate ideas, and towards a more objective, universal truth about the world, which can allow us to help ourselves better, treat each other better, heal each other better, take care of each other globally, and maybe that kind of progress might be able to actually solve, and this is not dramatic at all to say, but many of the world's crises, but only if we make progress and only if we're willing to be wrong. So thank you. Leave a like. Please subscribe to this channel. and comment below and tell me about a time when you've been wrong, and by admitting it, you got better and you improved your circumstances. Thanks.